In ArchiCAD, we have the choice of either placing dimension lines one by one or using the automatic dimensioning feature of ArchiCAD. In order to be more productive with the documentation, let's use the latter one. Zoom out and activate the arrow tool in the toolbox. Select all the elements on the first story using a selection rectangle drawn with the arrow tool. Select Document, Document Extras, Automatic Dimensioning, Exterior Dimensioning from the menu. Select Object Endpoints, and also select the wall hole size for both doors and windows. Check mark Dimension Structures, Dimension External Geometry, and Overall Dimension. Set the distance between dimension lines to 1000 mm. Select the Place to Dimension Lines on All Four Sides option. Finally, click OK to continue. Please note the status bar at the bottom of the screen. This displays the next step to complete automatic dimensioning. Click on any horizontal or vertical element, for instance the edge of a slab. This defines a direction parallel to the direction of the main building. The cursor changes to a hammer. Click outside of the building to place the dimension lines outside of the building perimeter. Dimension lines are placed instantly on all four sides of the building. Zoom in to have a closer look at the dimensions. Dimensions in ArchiCAD are associative, meaning they are tied to the elements they refer to. So if the element is moved or changed, dimensions follow these changes automatically. As mentioned earlier, dimension lines can also be placed individually. Open the S1 section view from the view map. Select the dimension tool from the toolbox. In the info box, select the X and Y only geometry method. Zoom in and move the cursor to the top vertex of a slab. The element information info tags will help to identify the slabs. When the cursor changes to check mark and finds a slab, click on it. Click on the corner of another slab above. Dots are placed where we click, indicating the dimensioned elements. Click the same edge one more time, and notice that the cursor changes to a hammer shape. Click to place the dimension line. Select the dimension line to add additional dimension points to it. Command-click on Mac or Control-click on Windows the corners of other slabs to add these points to the dimension chain. Do this in both bottom and top corners of all the slabs. If you click at the wrong place, move the cursor to the circle and click again. The mark will be removed. You may relocate the dimension line if necessary. When finished placing the dimension marks, zoom out to display the results. Now create a dimension line across the ground floor by clicking the vertexes of the columns. Start by dimensioning two columns and place the horizontal dimension line. Select it and add additional dimension points in the same manner as we did earlier. Zoom out to display the results. In the info box, change the dimension type to elevation. Set the marker type as presented on the screen. Zoom in and click to the bottom edges of the slabs to create a new elevation dimension line. Select it and extend it by adding elevation dimension points of all the slabs in the section view. Zoom out to display the results.